Hooray, yay! You finally completed the draining process of a successful paper publication. Congrats! Now you can kick back, place your feet on your desk, and rest on your laurels, right? Sure, but don't do that for too long. You see, just publishing is not the end of the story. You want to track whether your paper is having any impact. There are tools that can tell you if your publication is having impact. One such tool is the h-idex. The index was suggested in 2005 by Jorge Eduardo Hirsch. The h-idex is an author-level metric that measures productivity as well as citation impact of one's publications. The h-idex is a scholarly metric where the number of published papers and the number of times they have been cited is put into relation. Initially, that's how it started off, but over time, journals also have their own h-idex scores. So publishing in high h-idex journals increases your chance of being cited by other researchers. I'm going to give you three databases where you can find an author's h-idex. The first is Elsevier's Scopus. The second is Clarivate Analytics Web of Science. And the final one is Google Scholar. So I bet you want to run off and look at your h-idex right now, right? Let's do that together right after this short intro. Well, before you bother looking up an h-idex, you need to have been publishing. In order to show that we are capable of doing solid work in the laboratory, we need to publish, well, if we're doing research. Journals play an important role in selecting and curating the most important, relevant, and impactful work. We target journals, or we want to be published in journals, because they are a gauge of the quality of our work. This is because journals have a process which is called peer review, and they are able to subject your submitted work to scrutiny by offering it to or passing it to people who are also doing similar work to you and allowing them to give feedback on it and allowing them to see where there are improvements that needs to be made. So your peers, they will review the work, they will suggest modifications and improvements. But that those reviewing your work are blind, there are multiple levels of being blind, so they will not know who you are, or you will not know who they are, and then in some instances, the editors would also not know who submitted the work. So here's a tool for finding a journal to publish in depending on your area of research. I particularly love this tool because for me it's actually an easier way to find relevant papers in my research area, because when you put in the topic of your research, it then submits to you journals that you can go and get published in. It gives you the impact factor ranking next to it, and you're also able to see the authors, the people doing the kind of work that you're doing. So I feel like it's a better way actually of searching for journals in general, just to read, or in this case, with the intention of publishing in. So journals are published by publishing houses. They perform tasks like editing. These are the publishing houses. They do the proofreading, typesetting, online user management, marketing, etc. And it makes the published work available to readers. The publishing houses may make the publication available only to those who subscribe to the journal, the particular journal, and these can be institutions like universities. And in this case, they're called limited access journals. The publishing houses may make the application freely available to anyone who searches for it online, and in such cases, the journal is referred to as open access. For a limited access journals, the readers pay when they want to access the publications. For open access journals, you, the author, will pay so that the publishing houses will make their publication available to anybody who accesses it, not just institutions like universities. The biggest publishing houses include Springer, Sage, Wiley & Sons, Elsevier, etc. Journals tend to stick to a particular publishing house. So when it's your time to publish, you want to find a good quality journal in which to publish. How do you decide what a good quality journal is? You do this by looking at the impact factor of the journal and other bibliometric indicators. The first internationally recognized journal ranking index is the Scopus-powered Shimago Journal Ranking. The Scopus-powered Shimago Journal Ranking uses 3 years of citation to communicate the impact factor of a journal. There is also the Science Citation Index Expanded, previously simply known as the Science Citation Index. This ranking system is owned by Clarivate, which used to be the business arm of Thomson Reuters, and provides a rigorous score of a journal's impact. It first launched in 1964. There's also an up-and-coming ranking statistic or software, and that's the eigenfactor, and this is from the University of Maryland. It came out in 2008. You'll see differences in ranks depending on whether you use the Shimago or the Science Citation Index or the eigenfactor. And usually this is related to whether the scoring system eliminates self-citation, whether, you know, if an article refers to other articles within its own publication, or if it's weighted according to a stochastic measure of the amount of time researchers spend reading the journal. So there, these little factors that come in. And so these three are quite rigorous. Google also offers a ranking system. The Google citation system or ranking system tends to be less rigorous because it may be looking at even times where you were mentioning like a newspaper article or a blog post, those sort of things. So anything online, which means that it's not necessarily from other researchers or authors referencing that particular article. Okay, so this has been a video on journal ranking systems, your h-index, and finding reputable journals in your area to publishing. I love the tools that suggest a journal for you because they double up as a space to find articles related to your field. I hope this video was useful, and it is. If it is, please give it a thumbs up, and I'll catch you in the next video. God bless.